I think it's 17 years in the making, from the founding of our company to finally being able to take a step onto the pitch of the English Premiership. It's a huge, huge day for us. But you know, specifically, what we want to do is Under Armour claims to be an empowering brand. You know, it's something that gives little kids the ability to think that they can be more. Again, when someone walks into an Under Armour store, the question isn't, you know, how may we help you, or what would you, you know, what can you do for you today? The question is, what do you want to be? You know, a brand is meant to give you that little bit of edge, that little bit of advantage. And it's not just mental. It starts with the performance of the product. And so we believe we've built that in with the product that you'll see and the kid on field. And hopefully the players will have that too, is that we're going to put a little pixie dust on it and make everyone believe that they can be a little bit more.
That's one of the main things I've heard today over and over again, is the word heritage. And how important was it for you to make sure that Under Armour respected the heritage of Tottenham and the history of this club, which goes back a long, long way?
It was very important to us. We're a young brand. We're in our 17th year, so it's relatively like a little kid with a grandparent at some level. So we really wanted to attach our brand in the UK to someone that we can learn from and that we can grow with, and we thought Tottenham really gave us that ability. So the heritage is really important. It's something that we really wanted to respect.
We really wanted to honor, I think, the great history of Tottenham, and it's not our job to try to reinvent that. This is not a marketing platform or stage for our brand. You know, this is our job, is to demonstrate, you know, I think our understanding of that by how we respect the heritage of the club, and we bring many of those elements back into, you know, what you're going to see our boys wearing out there. We've been around, you know, we've been in the Bundesliga before. We've had terrific relationships, but again, as I mentioned, I think everything that we've done over our history, from, you know, our heritage in American sport there, into, you know, what it means from rugby, you know, into football. You know, we're ready for this deal. We've been ready for this deal for some time, and we made sure of that. And so, you know, our boys, when they go out on the pitch, is that they'll be second to no one in terms of performance or missing any advantage. And so we're going to advantage them in every way that they can to be the best prepared team, the best outfitted team, the best looking team too.
Something we heard on the grapevine is that if you chuck a glass of water over someone wearing this kit, that the water will just bounce off. Is that true? Because we'd like to do it.
There's a couple of different things. So we have a product called Armor Storm. It's a fleece product. You can wear that in rain and it completely repels the water. So you can throw a glass of water on that product and it'll completely repel. As it relates to the kit, it wouldn't necessarily repel the product, but it would wick the moisture away and it would dry quickly, but some of the moisture would stay on. But Armor Storm, go get it. It's a fantastic product.
Not sure the players will feel about it. We're going to do it anyway.